I didn't even have my starting stream up, did I? Hi there. Yeah, I'm a little absent-minded today. We just started without the starting screen. I don't care, you know. Every stream is going to be a little different. There, way. See? There you go. Starting soon. Go away and then come back. All right, now you're back. Yeah, you should be able to hear me now. Can you hear me now? I see my little meter moving. And I trust it. So I don't know if you were here yesterday. Yesterday was Monday. Monday was my scheduled e-date with Mistress Mord and the world famous e-girl streamer from South Africa, Cape Town, South Africa. And, you know, well, it could have gone better. Here's the thing. She was like, let's go. I was like, where do you want to go? Anywhere in the world. She's like, Tokyo. Great. I've been to Tokyo a million times. So we loaded up a plane and it immediately we had graphical issues. We couldn't even get off the ground. It was jittering really hard. And I've only seen that happen a couple of times only since I installed my aircraft carrier, which was 3 days ago. So the lesson was, is that given all the things I was trying to do, which was a live Discord call, OBS on the same computer and running this version of Flight Simulator that has this aircraft carrier is a no-go. But of course, there's no way I could have predicted that in advance. Yeah, especially if it's a special occasion. Because, you know, but she is, thankfully, just to jump to the end of the story, she's going to either, you know, this weekend or sometime, she really wants to do the Tokyo flight. And my plan is to, what I'm going to do today, I still have the aircraft carrier installed. I'm going to fly it a couple of times, and I'm going to uninstall it and put it on the shelf. Because basically what I've come to understand is that I can afford a $14 or $15 pack of aircraft carriers. But the catch is that I need a new $2,000 gaming computer. So I kind of have to add that to the tag if I want to run these aircraft carriers. Because basically, in order to run the aircraft carriers, I probably need a whole... my video card is okay. But everything else in my system is outdated. It's 3 years old. 3.5 years old. So I need a new i9-14900, right? I need DDR5 memory that's at least 6,000 megabits per second, right? Okay? And I need, you know, three... high-speed M, or four they come with now, four hard disk ports on the motherboard, right? None of these slow-ass hard drives. Even though I'm running this off a motherboard, but so I need faster memory. I need a faster memory and processor at this point. I'm pretty sure my processor is holding me back. And the speed of the memory, I do not think it's the video card, because the video card is never even barely running the fans when I'm doing this stuff, you know. But I am asking the video card to do a lot when I'm streaming and playing the game, because it's not just rendering the world, it's also compressing the video that streams out to the world via the internet. Well, I think my kitty wants to go outside. He's demanding out, so he wants me to open the door. So give me 1 second. Elbow. He doesn't care about putting on a show for the world. All right, he's out of here. No, he's just staring. He's just looking at the door. He's not. He's just looking at the door, rather pensively, as cats are wont to do. I'm poking you. Oh, I think he's going out. He's got a slit I made in the screen. All right. Well, again, graphics is one thing because I upgraded my graphics in January. You know, to the 2070 Ti from a 2070 Super to a 4070 Ti, excuse me. So I think the graphics card should have another 2 years of life on it. So my plan is to buy, basically spec out a decent desktop computer that's got everything I want in terms of the motherboard and the CPU and the memory. Those are the critical things. And then get it with the cheapest, either no video card or the cheap, they'll sell it to you with like a $30 video card in there. I think that's actually how it works. They won't say with no video card. And take out that video card and put the 2070 from my computer, my 4070 Ti from the computer in there, and the 2070, which I still have back in this computer, so they'll have two working computers. But one of them will be new and have the 47. And I'll still have room in a couple of years to upgrade it to a 50 series or 60 series card, you know, because every 2 years they come up with a new series. So 4 years, it could be 60 series. Who knows? Long story short is I have the aircraft carrier and I cannot fly it. Except we're going to try it today and I think it's going to work. I don't know why, but I just get that feeling. For one thing, we're going to try this moving carrier here. And it's not that close to anything, any major cities. Last time I tried, we were trying to go to Tokyo, a major city that has a lot of digital assets, buildings. But this is one of the aircraft carriers that I bought, that I have purchased. What are the choices? Runway, runway. But we can move around, which is nice. And the F4F Wildcat is the one I'm looking for. But we should see if we have a cool, like, Navy-based, naval. Yeah, I'm sure this is a naval one, because the Donald E. Running is an aircraft carrier. And we'll just see. And by the way, we'll know right away if this is going to work or not, because as soon as we got into the game, it started. It's okay when you're not moving anything, you know, like a still picture. Then it had the worst jitters. And plus, I checked the frame rate using my, you know, little Alt-R thing, and it was saying 9 frames per second. Ooh, wow, that's some frames per second. 9. Count them. So, you know, that's what it looked like. Except it wasn't just 9 frames per second. It was like 18 frames per second, but it, from different viewpoints. So let's just see. Whoops. Brake. I can already tell it's okay. All right. So put the parking brakes on. Now, yeah, it's fine. So what it was doing yesterday, just the slightest bit of movement. Okay, we're going to set the audio here. Hold on. Oh, yeah, I forgot to get gaming. Here we go. 1 second. Okay, so, yeah, this is not what it looked like the other day. In Japan, it, you know, I would have had to restart it. Oh, the other thing is, the time to boot Flight Simulator, it's incredibly slow. And it seems to be CPU-bit related, because it's a fast drive. It used to take 3 minutes, almost 3 minutes, and now it takes 6.5 minutes. And it's because of these 14 aircraft carriers. You can see they're extremely detailed. And this one is moving, which is pretty cool. Some of them are static. This is one of the ones that are moving. Now, one other thing I found out is that I have, and I barely ever use it, is I have a static camera that I could use to kind of just move around. So we can check out this whole aircraft carrier, like all the things are on. Like, that's an Orion P-39. I don't have that. An AWACS Orion, which I can't fly. I don't think all these are flyable. Oops. I think somebody's like jet wash or something. All these guys are in different colors. Those are actual. See, oh, it started jittering. There it goes. So it's fucked up. Okay, well, maybe not. Let's see if we can get back in the plane. Oops. Yeah. Okay. It's on the edge of getting messed up. No. I should be able to do this too. Go in this thing. It's like hangar. So you see, I fell into the hangar. That's fine. Although I'm stuck. Oh yeah, no. It automatically sets your plane to cold and dark. And by the way, this plane has a I gotta find it. Folding. Okay, it's not going to let me fold the wings because my battery is off, so I got to turn that on first. Master battery. So why can't I do folded wings? Does the engine have to be started? I don't think so. Okay, but this plane might have a bug in that regard then. Because you can fold the wings, and you would have the wings folded. All the other planes have folded wings. In fact, you see the folded wing tips. They all have foldable wings. And this plane has foldable wings, it's just for some reason. I guess the engine has to be running, we'll find out in a second. Okay, then there's parking, which is where we were. And then runway, which has the engine on. Now I want to check to see if this works with the engine running. Just doesn't seem to want. I think there is something in the code that says the plane must be stopped for and since we're on a moving carrier, it will not let me activate the folding and unfolding. But I think that's specific to this plane. Okay. All right. So if we want, we're gonna turn quick taxi on again. Okay, and we're gonna choose a catapult to take off. I just want to do this a couple times because I'm planning on uninstalling this. Oops. And not reinstalling it for a while. This plane is not set up for this thing properly, so I'm like railing it to the right. Okay, I guess that's in there. Okay. So let's see if they'll come in and do a safety check. Okay, I'm aligned to the runway. That means the safety, the green guys are the safety crew, and they're okay with everything. So now I do this, right? And then full throttle. And then he should, and then he's gonna wave me on. Right, or do I have to click this one? Oh, there we go. I will catapult it off. Whoa! Oh, didn't have enough juice. I did crash into the ocean. How did you know that was gonna happen? Now the cool thing is, just click here to try it again. I think I did not have my flaps down. Do you have to have, I don't think you need takeoff flaps. Oh wait, but see that's not good. So it didn't reset me. I wonder if I go to the hangar. Jeez. Yeah, I have to restart. When I used the F-18, you could restart. You know what I'm saying? And that's parking, but I'd have to repair myself. I don't know how to do that. Why is this thing circling too? And approach is not going to be a good thing to do because, yeah, I don't have any plane. The approach thing is cool because you can... is there two carriers down there? Oh no, that's where the location is. But yeah, we're gonna have to ditch this bad boy. But the thing is, I'm gonna try that one more time then. Let's try it this way. We're gonna go restart. Yeah, exactly. This should work. No. Let's try ready to fly. May not. Yeah, it did not. Interesting. Well, anyway, it's an add-on module, you know what I mean? Main menu. Now my feeling is, should we try this plane? Because I'm not 100% sure. It should be compatible with this, with the catapult launch. It seemed like it was. I should... Do we want to try that one more time? Yeah, we want to try that one more time. Hey, it's my game. Okay, so... runway, same plane. We're not going to fuck around, though. We're just going to do a catapult launch. By the way, this plane has a built-in catapult launch, which doesn't even require an aircraft carrier. We could try that, too. In other words, it simulates its own catapult, but I want to see if the aircraft system, it seemed to work. It did exactly what it's supposed to do. It just didn't seem to want me to go. Okay, let's do this catapult here and quick taxi. Again, it doesn't really want me to go right. All right, we'll switch to this one. All right, yeah, let's try to turn it off. So the other thing about this plane is that the other planes turn smoothly in this mode, which they're supposed to. And these plane, this plane is having a lot of trouble turning. Let's put it back on the... That's the only we can really do. Okay, so we're gonna do this. Oh, we may have to align to wind. This is definitely not a. The other plane flow was the FA-18, which is a standard carrier-based aircraft. It was a smoother experience in some ways. And it was. Oops, and they just disappeared on me. The fuckers. So we'll try the in plane catapult system, which is this 3 second countdown. Let's see if we have enough power to stay off the ground. Looks like this plane just does not have the goof. It does not have the umptions. And that's a good. The question is why. Also, one thing, am I doing something wrong in terms of this? Tail walk. Mixture is in full. Throttle, did I not get the throttle forward? Look at that. Oh, that's cool. Look how detailed that bad boy is, though. I tell you, see, if I need a better computer, and then we can frickin' do this. But as it is, I'm having a great-ass time. Look at that. It's getting sucked up into the aircraft carrier. Just checking out things there. We get here. Yeah, all the people died. Oh no, they're over there. Hello, people. And okay, if we go onto the runway, is our plane borked? We're just over there. So that's because this is the. Oh, wait a minute. Hold on. Maybe it was right. Hold on a second. Yeah, but our plane, the engine still... you can see the repeller is borked. You can't actually go anywhere in this plane. Is there a way of repairing crash damage through the toolbars? Weights and balance. I don't think there is. Carrier controls doesn't have... That's a different one. Okay, I'm just looking at some of these controls here. I don't think there's a way of fixing it. Flight assistant? No. Okay, just checking some stuff out that I don't normally look at. All right, let's try a different plane. Also, let's try a static carrier. Let's try the F-18 from a static carrier. We'll try the F-14. I know the F-18 works, and we're gonna use a static carrier because I think moving seems to be problematic. That one's moving. That one's moving. The one next to LA, it should be a nice day there. This one here is moving. This one is static. So that's where we're going to depart from. And we're going to switch to the F-14. F-14D. Sure. And we're going to see if we have better luck with the F-14. Because, yeah, twice in a row, it didn't seem like that plane had enough juice. And in the real world, propeller planes have plenty of. They're not the problem. They almost don't need catapults because they don't need that long of a takeoff. The other thing I did not know is whether you're supposed to make sure the the aircraft carrier is turned into the wind, and I'm not sure I did that. So there's a bunch of things I haven't tried yet. It's a new package, but as I say, I need a better computer. So this is what the F-14, not the F-18, the F-14, the F-18s are back there. There's a couple with folded wings. Now we're out, where wings are out for launch position, which is nice. We are going to attempt again to use quick taxi, head to this catapult. Now you can see it responds much better. Oh, maybe not. Oh, parking brake off. To this mode. Move smoothly left and right, as much as I want. So that is also true of the F-18. This is an easier mode to do this in. A little bit more. Okay, parking brake on. Flaps are okay. This is check. We're gonna have the safety crew come in. Safety crew is gonna give us a notification. They're okay with us. That's what that means. He's okay with us. We're gonna say we are okay in the cockpit by pressing this button. He's gonna do this whole thing here. Let me get the engines going. This button. We should just be ready to go. And there we go. And watch. Has no problems, I'm sure. No problems, but yeah, it's a little dicey getting off these things. But you're not supposed to use afterburners. That would be afterburners, and apparently it kills people on the deck if you do that. So. Okay, gear up. And flaps in, and let's make a turnaround for an approach. So at least we did not crash that one. And because we're not really going to go anywhere, I'm going to keep the wings out for turning approach. All right, we're going to make a turnaround. You got to land the same direction you took off, you know, the same way. You can't go back the way you came. You got to go circle around. So we're going to circle. Carrier. At least we're getting some kind of frames per second, right? Yeah, 90, 88. That's actually pretty good. The thing is, there's no buildings around. You expect really good frame rates. So, yeah. I mean, it's good frame rates. It's acceptable. But it's only because there are several carriers that are right next to large, like San Diego. All right, backing off the engines a bit. We're going to make a pass by this carrier here. We're going to move to landing. By the way, oh yeah, this carrier's not moving. See if we can get our gear to come down. We're going too fast for that. But when you go a little slower, it'll come down. And that's good because we need it. Oh yeah, I forgot. Frickin' air brakes. Without air brakes, we're gonna die, right? Speed brakes. What do we got? Come on, give me speed brakes. There we go. There's no way we'll go slow enough without the speed brakes. There they come. Okay, I start to bring up speed a little bit. Okay, do I have to switch back here? And hopefully we're gonna come in. Okay, oh, too slow. Okay, gear is down, flaps are down. So we are in a landing configuration. Oh, freaking tail hook. Always gonna forget that. Tail hook down. Okay, speed a little more. Okay, that green thing indicates we're getting a lock on shortly. I believe. I don't know. Too slow. Speed up. These are hard. I don't know if I'm going to master. You're high, sir. I'm not going around. I'm not waving off. Just put your fucking things out. Oh, that was way too high. Okay, so we're going to try again. Oh no, I did get caught. That? Because otherwise I wouldn't have stopped. But it's also not showing the arrestor cables. Oh no, they're way back there. So that was kind of a fake. Alright, we're going to try an approach. Let's see what approach does. Okay, that gives me a ball. So now we're on approach. I want that orange ball in the upper right to be in the middle. Yeah, correct glide slope. Alright, not too high. At least, we'll try it again. Walk around way too fast too. Yeah, because they're right there. Oh, I got one! That's an arrestor. That's number 4. No, I think it's number 3. Okay. That's fucking hard. Okay, we're going to do that again. This is kind of fun. Unsafe deviations. It's calling me a deviant. So the great thing is you can do this and you can set an approach. And then all you got to do is call the ball. So red is too low. Well. And if it goes up to the top, it'll say wave on. That orange one, it's already going too high. Too much power. Too much power, no power. Fuck are you, I'm not waving off nowhere. The light is too high. Yeah, I missed it. All right, let's try another one. Yeah, at least I'm consistently too high. You gotta be careful with the throttle. That is too bad. Is it auto throttling me? Is that the issue here? I've also been going way too fast when I try to lose altitude, so. Okay, so that's also too high. Come on, lower. I'm not that slow. You're slow. Call me slow. Okay, that's the ball. All right. I got the ball. I'm on the ball. Near the ball. That was terrible, because you're not supposed to catch wire number 1. Oh, that's wire number 2? No, that's wire number 1. There's only 3 wires? There should be 4. I think. Still, we survived that one. Well, you're gonna get good landing. They have you land on land on a thing that's the size of an aircraft carrier on a regular landing strip. And if you can't get good at that on land, then forget about it. But yeah, these guys have balls. But as you see, it's about, let's do this one more time. It's mainly about, I mean, first of all, I gotta learn what this track is, so I can get in there. Am I low? Now we're too high. You gotta watch that ball, that orange ball, and the airspeed, which is our different sides of the screen. Actually, I should move that. That's my bad. Overpowered. Also, he tells you some weird stuff.
Don't go any higher.
I'm not going higher.
Don't go
in, wave
off.
I'm not waving off. Boy, it's just tricky to get this thing in. Oh, I missed it. I missed it entirely. Let's try again.
Tricky!
Approach. We're gonna do a couple more approaches. Those are the tricky things. So that sound of the engine speeding up, and it does speed up. I'm not commanding that, though. Although it might be part of this approach sequence. I'm going to try to do this without putting my hand on the throttle. Catch one? I didn't catch one. All right, let's try again. Okay, when it does that, then I get more altitude than I want. And it slows down. I'm not commanding that, but I'm a little concerned that that's going to happen. I have to learn to deal with that every time. The sound effects each time. I'm not touching the throttle. Am I still way too high? Might be. You gotta come in so much lower than you think you have to. You think you're gonna hit the back of the ship. Right, you're slow. I've never gotten to nothing but a wave off, so. Too high. Alright, let's try again. It's going to do the same thing. It's going to shove my engines at full. Right there. And then I'm going to come back down again. I'm not doing that. Kind of frustrating. Yeah, well, he is. He'll say too slow, too high, too low. Call the ball is the best thing he can say. Call the ball means you're in a good thing. Also, there's this optical system on the back that you can look at. That's not too bad, though, because everything's green.
Don't go any higher. Don't go any higher. Way off.
Yeah, he's always waving me off. Well. Why did it not show me grabbing one of those wires? Yet, obviously, I didn't break. Let's try this fucking again. I'm gonna get it. I'm getting better. The trick is, you don't want to see the runway. You just want to see the back of the ship, you know what I mean? If you can see the runway, you're too high.
Clara, you're alone.
What? I couldn't understand what he was saying there. I'm never low, so blow me.
Roger, ball.
Call the ball. That means I'm okay. He didn't wave me off. Yeah, you're slow. I missed it. Bolter. Bolter means get the hell out. That was relatively close, though. He did not say, he did not wave me off, so. He said, at the end, he said bolter. Bolter means apply full power. And get the hell out. Go around, effectively. Bolter means you missed all of them. Okay, yeah. Low. Not concerned about the throttle. I don't really think that's the issue. You really just, you know, just a left hand thing.
You're a little fast.
Doesn't matter, buddy.
Don't go any higher.
Okay.
Don't go any higher.
I wonder if it's easier from the cockpit. This is one of those things that might be. Alright, that was the correct wire, too. That was the middle wire. Oh, it was the end wire. Shit. We're going to try one from the cockpit. It's a real different experience from here.
Clara,
you're alone.
What did he say? Hello? Hello.
Way off.
I'm also on a thing. Oh, fuck that. I mean, see, there's these systems here that you can see from the distance. That green that tells you whether you're on left or right. Was that the first one? Okay, one more from the cockpit. Okay, so we should be able to put that, what they call the ball, that sometimes of the ball in the HUD, right on the bottom of. Yeah, it's got some kind of auto thrust system that at least is showing. Okay, right. We should be able to put that ball. It's easier than it sounds, huh? Right on the bottom of that runway. Right there. It has to be a little higher than that, apparently. Why? Not that high. I don't believe I caught one of those wires. Okay, now I'm concerned, what are the views? Okay, there's that rear view, that's the Rizzo. This view I want to try. This is the pure HUD view. Okay. So this one should be the one that helps us really get in there. But we'll see, because you got your angle, you got all the information. I'm a little low though. I think I can try it again. I just got too low. This is interesting, it's the opposite experience. When you're doing from the other view, you're always too high. And this one, we're too low. I did get one of the wires, but I was too low. Let's try this one more time. Let's try not to go too low. So we're going to hold the nose up here. Keep that thing above the carrier until the last minute. Keep our... Look at that. It's a position where it's predicted where you're going to go indicator. It's a nose indicator. That's not really where your nose is pointed, though.
Clara,
you're alone.
I need to notice it. Okay, and that should be yellow. Okay, angle of attack should be yellow. Okay, that's not... No, that's not too bad, buddy. Trust me. Last wire. That wasn't too bad. All right. I want to show you something right here. Turn off the engine. Oops. Hold on, is there a cockpit? Yeah, there is, it's right here. So typically we're on the plane before we go into storage, of course. We're gonna fold our wings back. That's one of the main reasons why these planes are popular on aircraft carrier, is because of the swept wing design, which both has aerodynamic high altitude characteristics and allows for more of them to be stacked on the deck. And then we can go, okay, let's bring that back on. Put ourselves in the hangar. Where's the hangar? other hangar planes. You can actually text to the elevator, but not, I don't think, on static planes or something like that. Interesting. And that's, it automatically puts you in cold and dark. Oh, it left our cockpit up, which is cool. It's interesting, the other plane had problems folding its wings and unfolding its wings in the hangar. Okay, so we learned a bunch of stuff about a bunch of things. The F-14 works perfectly well. That P-40 did not. That World War II aircraft, that was an aircraft carrier typical craft. Just a beautifully detailed model. You can see why it's bringing my computer to its knees. It's got a little gantry crane that moves. Bunch of these are all, none of these aircrafts I own, or this, certainly that one I don't. I mean, the F-18s I own, but not, they don't, this version that has a wing, I do not, or those aren't flyable necessarily. Now, these are the devices and people standing around. And then there's a working elevator. Where is the elevator? Where would the elevators be? Are they here? Is that one of them? Who's the elevators? Or they come up this side here? Is that one of the elevators there? No. The elevator's on the other side. That might be one. Yeah, oh yeah, that's an elevator right there. It's hard to tell, but where that orange, yeah, where that line is there. And I don't think they work, unfortunately, on this one. Carrier controls. Yeah. It's not showing moving those. All right. But I think it said something about only moving carriers get this. Spotlight teleport. Okay. Yeah, these are the lifts, but I don't think they work. Because, yeah, theoretically, you can go from the hangar by the lift to the parking area. All sorts of stuff inside the superstructure we're going to kind of, not really fully fleshed out, but pretty cool. Yeah, as I say, I'm just playing with this a lot because I'm going to be uninstalling this so I can actually do my daily Microsoft Flight Simulator streams. Interesting how those lights work, kind of. All right, well, you know what? That's going to be it for the flight simulator today. Thank you for coming by. That was actually kind of interesting, and it did not mess up. But I did stop Discord and Steam entirely. And I had some things I haven't normally yet. As I say, those they're color-coded. They're on specific teams. There really are five teams that are color-coded on an aircraft carrier. And they're for the different, one of them kind of is a catapult management, there's a safety team, there's a flight, I don't remember what they all do, but there's five different teams, and all of them have to agree that you're allowed to go off, and like, you know, and there's one in the front who is the command boss, but the other teams have to signal him that everything's okay, and it's I don't remember what it was. I remember seeing a documentary on aircraft carrier flight deck operations, and I'm sure YouTube would have something of that nature, where it will tell you what the five teams are and what those five colors. Also, it's probably in the documentation for the Miltech Supercarrier Pro, which is what I purchased, and sadly I'm going to have to uninstall. There's a new computer next year, though. I'll reinstall it, and I bet it'll be awesome. You know what I'm saying? it's just I'm asking this three year old computer to do a lot. You know what I feel like doing though, along with my typical stream. I know we're running a little late, but I'm gonna play a little music. I played guitar yesterday. Wednesday, which is tomorrow, is gonna be the Christmas stream. But I'm gonna do on keywords. I'm gonna set up my keyword again. And we're just gonna have a little Ken's Lounge, okay? So give me about 5 minutes, and we're gonna play a little. We're gonna just play some random piano stuff. So we'll see you in about 5. Hey everybody, welcome to Ken's Lounge. How are you guys doing today? Happened a great Tuesday, are we? Thank you. Hope you're all doing well. So, let's see what's going on in my mind today. It was fun. We did some carrier operations today, and, you know, I think I got it out of my system. Because the thing that I like the most about Flight Simulator is going to places in the world and exploring them. And again, I played carrier simulations where you not only do you get to land and take off the carrier, you then get to shoot things, which you'll never do in Flight Simulator. But that's a very detailed simulation of taking off of a carrier with all those crews of people. I did enjoy that, and the landing is really good, except you need a little help with the glide slope, I think, than what they give you, because you don't get much at the early stages. And then we got to the previous session. I did the F-18, the carrier version, and this was the F-14, a carrier, another carrier plane. I tried doing that Curtiss, that P-40 Warhawk, which is a carrier-based plane, didn't seem to work too well, but it's not guaranteed to work with all planes. But I want to see if I have any other install planes that would be appropriate for a carrier takeoff. Because then I'm going to install it for a good long time until I get a new computer. Which would be like the end of next year, really. Maybe the summer, if I save up. And I do it kind of cheap, where I get like a bare-bones computer without a video card. Use the current one, but I still need new CPU, new motherboard, and new memory. So just about everything else, you know what I mean? Might as well get a new power supply and a case. Those aren't expensive. So just get everything except for the video card. Can't use my current memory. It's not DDR5. So what I'm thinking about today is, I don't know if you knew, but a whole bunch of streamers on Twitch are getting fucking suspended. A bunch of friends of mine, you know, ladies that I know casually, and my good friend, Mistress Mord, Siobhan, who I was on the date with yesterday, now got, you know, got a 3-day suspension today for no reason at all. No explanation. Said, oh, she was giving lap dances. You know, what is that bullshit? She was not giving anyone a fucking lap dance on stream. I watch her streams, and her stuff is much tamer than what's going on at least 20 people's streams. Some of which have been getting suspended. I admit, you know, Aurora Star got a 30-day, she got an indefinite ban, which is 30 days. Mistress Moore just got a 3-day ban. And B-Fit Pilates gal, she's super wholesome. She's banned right now. And I think Morg Pie is banned, but yeah, she was kind of doing it. I don't understand it, and I don't think it's right. I'm going to write after this stream, I'm going to write a strongly worded X. I'm going to start write a strongly worded X to DJ Clancy 999, the president and CEO of Twitch. He said on stream that he thinks that the ban system is unfair. They should do things like warnings, you know? And he said, if you have the sexual themes tag on, you shouldn't be getting banned for having sexual shit going on in your stream. You know what I mean? None of which has happened. So, in fact, it's gotten worse. And that's what I'm going to say in the mail. That's all I'm going to say. I'm going to say, look, you said this at TwitchCon, you know, and just to know, maybe you're an ineffectual CEO, but apparently no one at Twitch is doing that. You know what I mean? Is taking into account whether you have the sexual themes turned on or not. You'd think that would solve the problem. Just don't put advertisers that are sensitive to adult material on anyone's channel if it says sexual themes on it. Nope, they don't give a shit. It has nothing to do with whether you tag your stream as sexual themes or not. It's just how many reports you get, and these girls are getting a lot of reports. I'm surprised they even knew about Mistress Mord. She's like literally 1/10 of the size of the girls who are doing the naked meta, or just whatever. But I always told her, I talked about bans, like, you're gonna get banned, don't mess. And Kitschy Key, right. No, you know, Kitschy was right. She's currently banned, and she's on Kick, and so is Aurora. And she just said she's banned for being sexy. You know what I mean? It's not, there's no rhyme or reason to it. It's not fair. And they're also banning lots of other people, though. I've watched the ban stream, and there's like a record number of bans going on. It's not just the girls. People are. It is the girls there, but if you just look at the frequency of bans that are recurring over a period of time, it's like Twitch is ban happy right now. It's like, or suspension or whatever. I don't know how that works. What's going on? Whether it's the algorithm is just flooded with, you know, people gaming the system to get people banned, and then there's no appeal system because they don't have enough employees. It's not a great situation. And I feel for people this is their livelihood, you know? This is not my livelihood. I give a shit if I get permanently banned on Twitch. You know what I mean? I'll be bummed out for 2 days, whatever. I might go on Kick or whatever, but I'm not making any money from Twitch. These people have their livelihoods being fucked with, and I don't think that's right. You know, nobody's really standing up for them. And even the CEO who's kind of standing up for them is not doing a good job and not getting that shit turned around. And it's, you know, every time this happens, well, specifically every time Mord gets banned or suspended, I get really grumpy fucking about Twitch, you know? And I'm like, what the fuck am I doing even, you know, supporting this platform, putting any money into it or anything? And I tell a lot of people right around these kind of times, don't expect gift subs and bits from me, because I'm not buying anything from Twitch until they fucking tell me what's going on, and they won't tell me what's going on. And eventually I kind of forget about it and start, you know, giving gift subs and bits away. But at times as this, I'm like, I don't want to support a business model like that. Especially if the CEO said, no, it's not fair, we should change it, and then nothing changed and just got worse. So some angry music for Twitch. Fuck you, Twitch. Well, they give you an explanation, and the explanation is super vague and wrong. You don't get to see a clip of what you did. They don't save that for that, you know. It's super rude the way they did it. And the appeals process is almost always completely useless. And if you're like Aurora and you got indefinitely banned, I don't think they'll let you appeal for 30 days. You know, so that's why it's a 30-day ban. I just somebody who saw who got somebody who got unbanned on the unbanned feed, who's been banned for 2.5 fucking years. Just got unbanned. What do you do to get banned, suspended for 2.5 fucking years? Did she bone somebody buck naked on stream? I want to know. Certainly at the spicy sites, the ladies who have what it's got to make money on a spicy site can make money on a spicy site. But what they cannot do is build a community, because they can deal with, they can effectively talk to individuals who want to pay to see them or whatever, make a spicy video specifically for them or show, here's a package, you know, blah. But the individuals who are viewing that person at the spicy site are not interacting with each other, okay? That's what makes a community. So I'm in Ward's community, which means that there's other people in her community that I talk to kind of on a regular basis. It's not just Ward. That's what a community is. Spicy sites don't build community, period, ever. And you need a community if you're going to be successful in the long run, or some kind of community. And yes, you can do spicy. There's plenty of women who make a lot of money on spicy sites. And I know once you used to stream and just don't really stream anymore because the hassle, and they made more money on OnlyFans and Pornhub, you know. So why should they? But people like Mord, they don't just want to stream, they want to build a community, and good for them. And they should. So that has to be Twitch or Kick, but Kick is kind of lame. So the spicy sites and the community sites, yeah, or one or the other, have to work together. You have the community site, and you say, oh yeah, go visit my spicy site if you want to see me do more. And at the spicy site, you know, hey, you announce, hey, I'm streaming live on Twitch, and they work together to build an audience. If you really put effort into it, obviously my spicy site doesn't do well, but I will keep trying. I'll keep posting content. I think my entry fee of $7,000 a month is a little steep, but somebody will bite. I think at some point, you know. Hey, what? No. Okay. We gotta get back to the piano playing here.
1, 2, 5.
Thank you.
had it down a while. Got the rest of the song down. Joe Jackson. I noticed that you pick up a lot of clicking sound with my current setup, where my mic is. My mic is aimed at me, but still a lot of clicking sounds. You're not hearing any audio sound from the keyboard. Keyboard isn't making any actual sound through the speakers, it just goes right through the board. But if you hear clicking, it's because you're hearing it through the mic. Which, by the way, reminds me, when I'm going to be doing my... tomorrow will be a Christmas music rehearsal Wednesday, the following Christmas rehearsal Wednesday. And then we'll do the actual Christmas Day and Christmas Eve streams, 3 hours of music. I'm going to have the microphone turned off. So you're not going to hear that. It's going to sound like this. Because you can hear, there's definitely a lot of noise leaking in from the microphone. I'm just trying to figure out if I can get a better mic situation. But boy, I got a million microphones, and I can always get a million more. Probably one might help. This is a very nice microphone. I mean, it's a 2020 Audio Technica. I mean, it's perfectly good. Let's play a few more songs, though. What the hell? Why not? Oh, the sound is good. It just picks up a lot that I don't want it to. But my voice sounds good. I guess my audio is okay. Sounds fine. I'm just talking about the clicking sounds from the keys, me hitting the keys. I can kind of hear this when I play. See, I listen to my VODs, and I am trying to improve various things. I kind of like the picture. This element is fine. I'm not gonna change this very much, I don't think. But I might move this thing. My Twitch sign. It's right above my head. I think I'll move a little further towards the corner. Might be better. I wouldn't block it as much. Little things. But the audio quality I'm always worried about. As I say, the mic is a good 18 inches away from my actual voice or talking, so you can't see it, which is nice. But it picks up a lot of sounds. So it's not ideal. It's not bad, though, as I say. I just think there's eventually could be improvements made. Okay. Play a little bit more. Oh, we're almost, yeah, we have another 15 minutes or so. What do I feel like playing? I don't know. There's a man who leads a life of danger. Everyone he meets, he stays a stranger. With every move he makes, well, another chance he takes. But he won't let us say tomorrow. Beware of pretty faces you may find. Pretty face can hide an evil mind. Oh, be careful what you say. Don't give yourself away. You won't live to see tomorrow. was Secret Agent Man. Secret Agent Man. The spirits run and they take away your name. Well, look out, Agent Man. Secret Agent Man. This mysterious life you choose is a deadly game. Sunning in the Riviera one day, then bleeding in a Bombay alley next day. Oh, don't let the wrong word slip when kissing persuasive lips. Oh, you won't live to see it in my row. Well, Secret Agent Man, Secret Agent Man. Well, they've given you a number and they've taken away your name. Look out, Agent Man, Secret Agent Man. This mysterious life you choose is a deadly game. Talked about this. With Patrick McGoohan, who was, then went on to do the Prisoner. You know, it was the predecessor of the Prisoner. Was it? Yeah. Could have been different characters, but it wasn't. That's what I mean, yeah. Okay, still, it's cool. Piece of trivia there. Thank you. All right, one more song, just a Ram song. I gotta go back to work. Thank you for coming by, though. Thanks for coming by. I'm going to quit too pretty soon. If you liked my playing tonight, as every night in Ken's Lounge, if you appreciate it, all I ask you to do is that you sidle up to the bar, you order yourself a fancy cocktail. Not for me, for yourself, please. And remember to generously tip the wait people here. They do on average 9 children each, and you know, every little bit helps. It used to be 7, but each one has had 2 children since yesterday, last time I told that joke. So now they have 9 children on average. Tomorrow will be 10 children. They're very prolific. So please, a lot of tips for them, you know. Thank you again for coming. Tomorrow's stream will be Christmas music rehearsal. That's Wednesday. Thursday is going to be guitar. Of course, obviously, Microsoft Flight Simulator first. I think we'll do more carry operations until I have to uninstall, which I think is going to be Thursday. What else would be? Friday, maybe that's when we'll do a recording studio stream, which I've been talking about in the recording studio. And Saturday or Sunday will be the extension of the Mistress Moore Tokyo tour that she's requested. So one of those. Well, I appreciate it. Again, it's pretty much every day around the same time-ish, this time-ish. So I kind of keep that consistent streaming activity. And it's pretty easy, as I say. I'm taking a break from work. Got my work computer there. It's ready to go. I can send some emails. Just get back to it. And I've already been in the office for 5 hours since 7 a.m. So basically, it's a completed work day anyway. But it doesn't matter. When I'm working from home, I can definitely take an hour break. And it's fun, really fun to do stuff I would normally do anyway. Take a break and play Flight Simulator or some music and do it with, be able to chat with a few people here and there, which is really cool. So I'm having a great time and I plan on keeping doing it. So enjoy the rest of your days, your Tuesday, and we'll see you on a Wednesday.